Hey everybody, Dr. Mujtaba Sheikh here from The Dentalist. Did you ever notice a black spot with a cavity on your tooth? What is this black spot? And how this is formed? And what is it called? What are the factors involved to cause that? We're gonna talk about this and much more in today's video, just stick with us. So today we're discussing about that black spot, which is called as dental caries. Yes, you guessed that right. So dental caries may be defined as a complex and a dynamic bacterial disease which involves demineralization and remineralization of inorganic substance of the tooth as well as destruction of the organic substance. Sounds difficult. Let's make it easy for you. By this time, I assume you already know that the tooth consists of layers, namely enamel, dentine, then there's pulp, and then there are supporting structures of the tooth. So the enamel is the outer surface, the surface that you usually are able to see when someone smiles in front of you. That's the enamel. And yes, it is the hardest part of the human body, even harder than your bones. But unfortunately, the decay begins here. So the enamel consists of 96% of the inorganic substances. Those inorganic substances are present in the form of enamel prisms, which are formed by crystals known as hydroxyapatite crystals. These hydroxyapatite crystals gain further strength when someone takes fluoride in their food and water or even in their toothpastes. The hydroxyapatite crystals are then converted into fluoroxyapatite crystals, which is a much stronger form of the inorganic substances present in the enamel. When the hydroxyapatite crystals are converted to fluoroxyapatite crystals, it also helps in preventing tooth decay, as fluoride has been proved as a mineral to prevent decay on the tooth. After we've talked about the inorganic substances of the enamel, we should also talk about what organic substances the enamel contains. Those are mainly proteins, namely enamelin, tufalin, and the likes. And yes, not to forget, along with the inorganic substances and the organic substances present in the enamel, it also consists of water. That's how it forms hydroxyapatite crystals. The hydroxy comes from the water and the enamel content. So now you have a clear idea of what this outer surface of the tooth consists of. It has inorganic substances, organic substances, and water. That's how it becomes the hardest part of the human body. But being the hardest part brings many responsibilities with it. So whenever you eat something sweet and it's left on the tooth for a while, the bacteria start acting on it because the bacteria love sugar. So when they act on it, there is a byproduct that's produced in the form of acid. That acid is responsible for the demineralization of this outer surface. When the tooth demineralizes, the normal mechanism of healing comes forward and remineralization starts. So this process of demineralization by the acid produced by bacteria and then remineralization from the normal mechanism of healing results in dental caries. But we cannot only blame sugar for such a bad disease. There has to be something else. So always remember, dental caries is a multifactorial disease. There's not just one factor involved, which is sugar. There are a lot of different factors that contribute in the causation of dental caries. So let's discuss what factors could actually cause dental caries. So for you to remember, there are five factors responsible for causing dental caries. The first one to begin with is the bacteria itself. So the bacterial count really matters. If there are less bacteria in your mouth, there is less chance of the bacteria acting on the sugar which is present on the tooth. And that's why there's a drastic variation in the occurrence of dental caries in different human beings. There are many people in which there is less bacterial count and less normal flora present in the oral cavity, whereas there are some which have a lot of bacteria in their mouth and they can't help it because it's normal flora. It's going to be there in their mouth. And so, in result of it, they get more dental caries. Now, the second factor involved is like how we discussed, it's the type of food you eat. It could be sticky, sugary food that it's hard to be removed from the tooth, and that can mainly result in causing dental caries. So you gotta be careful what you're eating. That's the second factor. Now, as we discussed in the beginning, the third factor is the amount of fluoride along with other minerals present in the enamel. If the fluoride content or other essential minerals are less in the tooth, it can also weaken the tooth, resulting in getting dental caries quickly because there will be less of prevention mechanism going on. Now, since we started studying dentistry, we've been hearing that saliva is a natural protector, is a natural buffer. It doesn't let acidity stay in the mouth. It neutralizes all the acids that come in the mouth. So what really happens is if there is less saliva, the bacteria would more powerfully produce acid, and there will be no saliva to counteract it, to neutralize it, therefore resulting in more decay. But on the other hand, if there is adequate salivary flow, it will not let bacteria produce more acid. Rather, if they even produce acid, the saliva in your mouth is going to neutralize it, preventing you from dental caries. And that is why people with dry mouth are more prone to getting dental caries. Now for the fifth factor, I'm going to give you an example from our daily clinical routine. Now usually when pediatric patients visit us, their parents complain they eat a lot of chocolate, sweets, and that's why they've got dental caries. First and number one advice you give to those children or to their parents is to minimize the time period that they get exposed from those sweets, chocolates, and candies. They should set a particular time throughout the day in which the child is allowed to eat as many sweets as they want, and then they brush their teeth properly. This will help them get rid of the sweets, chocolates getting stuck in their mouth all day long. This means they are also fulfilling their desires to eat chocolates and candies, but at the same time, they're not giving much time to the bacteria to act on that sugar present on the tooth. And get what I'm saying? So the fifth factor is the time for which the sugar stays on the tooth for the bacteria to act on it. So we're done with the five factors that are actually responsible to cause dental caries. I hope by now you understand why dental caries is called as a multifactorial disease. Let's revise the factors really quick. The first one was the bacterial count. The second is the food that we eat. The third is the minerals present in the tooth. The fourth factor is saliva. And then the fifth one is the time, is the exposure time. So you see, it's a balance of all these factors that need to be maintained in order to prevent dental caries. Now you know what to do with your next patient for preventing them from dental caries. Yeah, the takeaway message from me is resisting from chocolates is not easy, but you gotta do that for your teeth. Anyway, there's a quiz waiting for you down in the description below. Go solve that quiz and let me know what you scored in the comments below. That's all for today, my friends. The next video will be on the pathology of dental caries. So we'll discuss the bacteria involved and how they act on it, the whole processes and everything. I will make sure I make it easy for you. And yes, like our Facebook page and subscribe to our YouTube channel and give this video a thumbs up if you found it useful. This is Dr. Sheikh saying goodbye to you. Take care till we meet again.